I'll discuss pathfinder problem based on electric field, not electric field, charges and oscillations. Good question, useful. We are given three charges, all three are having mass m, and they are connected by inextensible non-conducting string. These are the strings, they don't stretch and they don't conduct. That's the ideal string as we need in such problems. Now these masses are held in free space. Only problem is that it is not in straight line. There is a small deviation, very very small angle, maybe you can say just very small angle. It is just the magnified view which I have drawn. These are held by some non-conducting mechanism and suddenly we release all three simultaneously in the space. This is how it was when it was released. That only that much is given in the problem. We have to find what is the time period of oscillation of this system. Now if you look such kind of a diagram, our mind gets confused. But as I always say, nature likes symmetry, our mind likes symmetry, physics likes symmetry. Who told you that you should look at the diagram in the manner as which author has told you? Instead of using this as the reference line, can't I draw my own line as a reference line? Means which is just making equal angles. And instead of seeing is this, can't I see it like this? Now I'll slightly increase the angle. But angle is same, small angle, but I'm just increased it. So that was the original problem. That is how small angle is shown. Maybe that side, I just draw it again. That is called lateral thinking. All of you do it, intuitively you do it. So once we get symmetrical diagram, our mind starts working. Now it's easy to work on. So this is the arrangement. No change has happened, only the way we look at the diagram that has changed. Let this distance, when this small angle is there, when it was released there was small angle, let this distance be x. Where is the center of mass of this system? If I take this as a reference line, from one reference line you can find the center of mass, and once you find the center of mass, make that as the reference line. That is my advice. That is the advantage of center of mass. Why I am finding center of mass? There are interacting forces, tension forces, string is giving tension, forces are just trying to push each other because of electrostatic force, and the whole system is not getting any external force. So if I get this center of mass, I know center of mass will not shift. So that is where I will calculate the location of center of mass. You do it yourself, it will be x upon 3 from here. I'm not doing it, center of mass, you can easily calculate. If you take this as a reference, this m into x is equal to 3m, so x is, x dash is x upon 3. That is how we calculate the center of mass. This is x upon 3 and the below it will be twice x upon 3. This much. Let me call this x upon 3 as y. So y is nothing but x upon 3. And now, because x upon 3 is linked to my angle, I'll be later on using it. Now let me, you can take y or you can take capital X, no problem. Take capital X. And I shift my reference line, now the line of center of mass. Because of symmetry it is on this line, and because of the masses I have calculated it is somewhere there, which is x upon 3, which I put as capital X. Now from this reference line, these two masses are at capital X and these are at, accordingly you can calculate, twice small x upon 3. Convert in terms of capital X, I am not converting, I don't need it. I will use only this much. Now, for the simple harmonic motion to happen, there has to be a restoring force which opposes my motion. So let me see whether I am able to get a restoring force which opposes my motion. Now here, next thing we have to do is, I have taken the whole system and I have found the center of mass. Now I don't need to choose the whole system because I want to see the motion within the system, which is the simple harmonic motion, which I presume, and we have to prove it also. Center of mass is not moving, but within the system, masses are moving and having this simple harmonic motion, which I presume. So I will take now these two masses. Now you can ask why I have taken this. This is based on my experience. I can say I like symmetry. I have taken this. You could have taken this mass also. and taken this as the reference. Same thing you do yourself for this mass. I'll do for these two masses, you do yourself for this mass. So now this is my system. My system is being interacted by the forces here and the forces here. What is the acceleration of my system, this new system, with respect to center of mass? The acceleration is x double dot, because the distance of these masses from the center of mass in vertical direction is x double dot. So my mass into acceleration, mass is total twice m. This is my mass is twice m into acceleration. And in this direction, what are the net forces in this direction? F net along x. If I find this, and if I get negative sign there in the F net, then it means there is a restoring force. And let us see whether restoring force is linked to the distance, proportional to the distance. How it is linked, we'll find that also. Let me first write theta is equal to small x upon L. As I repeat, I have taken whole distance, small x initially, and capital X is small x upon 3. So theta is, this small x is 3x, 3 capital X upon L. This is the value of my theta. Because theta is very small, that is why I have written like this. Theta is arc upon radius. Theta here is in radians, not in degree. Now, next thing which comes here is, I have to find what are the forces acting on this mass, and this mass. If I calculate for this mass, I get for this mass also. Here I don't need, because I am not using this as a system. I am using this. I need forces, total forces acting on this system. So if I calculate on one, I'll multiply by two. So I get the forces. Now, what are the forces? How they are? So just see like this diagram again. I'm drawing, taking time, but anyway worth it. And this is how the angle is theta. This angle is theta. This angle was theta. I've already calculated. And this was the center of mass, and this is that capital X. I'm not writing small x anymore, because I'm working in terms of capital X. So this mass will have force because of this charge, which is say F1. And value of F1 is K Q square upon this. Length is twice L. We will ignore slight variation in length. That assumption has been done, because theta is very small. Very small oscillation will happen, tuk, 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 kind of a thing. The time period should be very short for such kind of very high frequency oscillation should happen. So this is approximately twice L. Theta is small, so this will be 4 L square. And F2 is the force on this. This is F1 because of this charge. And F2 will act in this line. So F2 is K Q square upon L square. Because this distance is L, this is L, this is twice L approximately. Now, don't ignore the tension due to thread. The thread has tension. Thread pulls the mass. Thread is stretched. Thread itself is experiencing stretching force. But because it is experiencing stretching force, it is pulling the mass. So thread is also pulling the mass. So now, how do I solve this? There are variables, lot of variables. Tension has come, F1 has come, F2 has come. One is very simple. I write this as F. If F1 is F, F2 is 4F. So F1 is F. And F2 is 4 times F. Very simple. This is how I write 4 times 4. And this was F. So F2 is 4 times F. I cannot equate forces in this direction without taking acceleration into consideration, because I am saying they are moving about center of mass. I cannot equate forces straight away, because there is motion in this direction also. What is the direction in which there is no motion? String. String is inextensible. So this mass is not having any acceleration in this direction. Since there is no acceleration in this direction, I can equate F1 cos theta plus F2. F1 cos theta plus F2 is equal to T. Theta is very small, so F1 plus F2 is equal to T, approximately. That has to be done, otherwise you can't solve this problem. So that approximation you have to accept. Theta is very, very small. Very high frequency oscillations will take place. Now F1 is F and F2 is 4F. So it is approximately T. So T is approximately 5F. And this is a good approximation, not a very wild approximation. T is equal to 5F. Now let me find out what are the net forces towards positive X. This is center of mass. Now these are all capital X I will measure. So in that direction, the mass was twice mx double dot, mass into acceleration will be equal to net force upwards. Net force upwards will be F2 sine theta minus T sine theta twice. Don't forget to do that, because I am not taking this mass. So better keep on drawing this line repeatedly, because then you will forget and that silly error will spoil all the hard work. F1 tension, F2 cos theta, F2 sine theta, T sine theta, T sine theta. Complete the diagram so that you don't miss out forces on that side. These two are added to give this resultant. Because I have taken 2m, both the masses, so I have to take both side forces. I have done twice. So it becomes 2, I'll just now remove, mx double dot, sine theta is theta, and theta I take out, theta, F2 minus T. What is F2 is 4F, so I write theta, F2 is 4F, and T is 5F. So I have got the result which is favorable. I have got that side on in negative. If you get net that side in negative, and also one more thing will be required, at least first part has come, minus F. This is minus F into theta. What is value of theta? Theta is 3x upon L. So this is M capital X double dot is equal to minus F, and theta is 3x upon L. 3x upon L. So I get x double dot is equal to minus 3f upon ml into x. This is what? Equation of simple harmonic motion. The restoring force depends on the displacement and it is opposing the motion. And what is this? This is omega square. So my omega square or omega will be, which is 2 pi upon t, is equal to square root 3f upon ml. 3f. What is the value of f? This is the value of f. So let me put the value of f, and this is equal to q square upon 16 pi epsilon naught L square, because this is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, 4, 16 pi epsilon naught L square. If I do any error, just correct it yourself. So it is q square upon, f is q square upon 16 pi epsilon naught L square. So I get here 2 pi upon t is equal to q upon 4. I take this out. It is 3 upon m L cube. This L cube, I don't know. I hope it is correct. L cube should come or not. Anyway, check. This is L cube is coming. Maybe it's okay. So the time period is 8 pi. T will be 8 pi upon q. M pi epsilon naught L cube upon 3. This should be the answer. In case there is any inaccuracy, correct it, but this is how it has to be attempted.